Hello, my friends. How you doing? I had to wait until the nighttime to go ahead and put this message for you together. That way the dog's asleep and it's not barking, interrupting us. But just want to let you know I made it back on Friday from my cruise. And I'm going to kind of give you a lowdown of all what took place, the things I liked and the things I didn't like, and more overall score of my outing. So here's the thing. When you get off your car and get ready to get on the boat for, the first time, you have no idea where to go. You know, I finally found a desk. I asked somebody. They told me just to drop off the bags at a certain area, me and my son. So we did that. Mind you, at this time, I'm in the wheelchair and he's pushing me. So as we're going up to the boat, he's steering me around different locations, and there was some where some of the bumps are a little hard to get over, to where I was almost falling over out of the wheelchair, so you need to be really careful. But when you get on the boat, again, you don't know where to go. The only reason why I knew what we had to do was because I'd been watching so many YouTube videos that I knew that I needed to go to the muster area. You make sure you go to muster. If you don't, they can kick you off the ship or fine you. So what you want to do at the muster, you just stand there, watch a guy put on a life vest, and he shows you how to put it on. If there's an emergency, he tells you where to go, and he also tells you where your lifeboat is. So you need to make sure you follow directions. And that's it. It only takes about a minute. And when you're done there, we went to our room. And it wasn't open yet. So at the time, we decided just to go ahead and find something to eat. Now, there are some places on the boat where you have to pay extra to eat there. But there's also the places where you get food for free. So first we went to Shack. And that's Shack's place, of course. And we went to his place. He has a barbecue place and he also has a chicken place. I believe we went to the barbecue place first. When we got our food, and this wasn't just me, it was my son too, but there was no taste. We just didn't taste anything. Even putting the sauces on there, drowning them in sauce, is still, there was no taste in any food. So we didn't even finish what we had. We moved on to another place. And this time we went to Guy Fieri's. He has a hamburger place and he also has a barbecue place. We went there and we each got a hamburger. The hamburgers really weren't something to write home about. They still didn't have no flavor. And you went and used his famous donkey sauce, I think it was. That doesn't do any better for you. So again, we left the food there, and we, at this time, you know, we're hungry, we're dying for food. So we went to Shack's place again, and the only thing that they had there this time at the chicken shack was chicken fingers or chicken strips. So we got those, and again we fell into the same routine. Nothing was tasting good. Now, I hadn't heard this only just from me and my son, but I had heard other people saying the same thing. So finally, we found the deli and the pizza place, and those two had good food. They were worth eating. They actually had some taste. So, you know, I recommend those two places to go to, especially when you first get on the boat itself, because you have so many people and everybody is, you know, hungry at that time. And you go to the buffet, which is the first place we ate at, I believe it was, I said. But we did eat there, and there was just no flavor. You only get six things to choose from. Sure, they have the desserts, but there's just not that many entrees to eat from. And it's the same on one side as it is on the other table. It's the same thing. They got four stations, and all four stations have the same food. And that was something that we got up and walked away from too, because we couldn't taste the food. So then we ended up at the pizza place and the sandwich place, and those were good. Those held us over. By the second night, we realized that the best thing that we could do is go and try the dining room. Now, when you talk about the dining room, they have a set menu each day, and you pick from that, and you can have as much as you want. If you want a steak, two steaks, get them. If you want anything else, you can double up. That the dining room had the taste. That was good. Real good food there. You get the full range. You get, everything from your main dish. You get an entree. You get the dessert. You get everything. That was good. Service came quick. One thing I do want to talk about too, though, is, some of the packages that they ask you to purchase before you get on the boat, on the ship, you can actually buy them when you're there. We were given the $100 credit on our account, and it's the account that you have money on while you're there that you can spend it any way pretty much that you want. We were going to buy the drink package for sodas because I don't drink alcohol, and that was about maybe $36, for 4 days, 36 around there. And we went ahead and put that on the card, and that took it off from the credit. So I was able to have sodas, as many as I wanted when I wanted them. But the package deal for the alcohol was really expensive, maybe $60 a day, and that's just crazy. But people were buying it up. I mean, that was the first thing everyone did when they got on the boat was go to the alcohol. So we were able to get around to some of the other places, but going back to the diner, that's the place for me. That was the place that we just stayed at for the rest of the 4 days. And off and on, we would go to pizza or we'd go to the sandwich, late at night. That was great to hold us over. Now, when it comes to cash, you don't necessarily need to bring any, really. I didn't have any money at all. We used a card the whole time, which, like I said, I had that $100 on there. But, the only time that you're gonna need money is, for the casino. You can always also put money on your card. You would need it there. I think there was a couple other places on the boat that you needed it, but if you go there without anything, that's fine. And you're, of course, if you're gonna get off and go to Ensenada or go to Catalina, of course you're gonna need money. But you gotta remember some of those expeditions, especially in Catalina. If you want to go see the blowhole or go around riding in the golf cart or going on hiking or going on excursions, riding on horses, all that costs extra money. So you need to make sure you have it there. And again, I believe I might, we didn't do it, so I really couldn't tell you, but I believe you can put the charges on your card and pay for them, at the end of the trip. But as we go, 2, 3 days, some good thing is the shows that they had there, the entertainment, that was good. We also had, they did a lot of trivia days where, they would give away prizes if you got trivia correct. That was fun. So there's things to do on the ship itself. The reason why I didn't get off was the, handicap issues that I have. After the first day, I realized that we're just gonna have to ditch the wheelchair. It wasn't gonna work. Some of the areas were too tight to move around in. My son was having a lot of difficulty pushing me around, and just too many people. It was hard when you would push a button to get on an elevator, and everybody just runs to the elevator, and you're the one that pushed the button, but you don't get in. That was a lot of hassle that we were having. So that plus some of the elevators or some of the levels you can only get by a certain elevator. There's elevators on both sides of an atrium that they have in the middle, and sometimes you would have to take one elevator up, cross over, and take an elevator down to where you want to get to. And that was really confusing. Didn't have, you have your map on the phones, but on your phone when you get there, but No, you make sure you download the Carnival Hub that they have. But, it was still hard to read and still hard to figure out where things were at. We were still getting lost. But, you can plan everything right there on your phone, and it helps out, keeps your itinerary, keeps it all right there in front of you. So when something pops up, even when you go and reserve your seat at the dining room, do it 10 minutes before you get there, and your seat will be ready, and you can just walk right up to the front, show them your number, and they'll take you to the seat. That was good because a lot of people weren't doing that. They were still waiting, to get called in. So you want to make sure you do that. But yeah, it's just, I was thinking I was coming to the point where maybe I should be not, drinking, and maybe I'll have some more fun. But I don't drink, and neither does my son, so we stayed away from the alcohol. But other than that, the inside was good. It was fun. We did some things there, but some things cost extra. The spa costs extra. Sushi, if you want that to eat, that costs extra. The steakhouse costs extra. And there's other places, the spa, that costs money. But then there was one time we went, they have a bunch of shops there, but there really wasn't anything that interested me on the ship to buy. But my son is into watches, and they have a watch store there. And they're having a demonstration on one of the brands they have. They have brands, that are like Citizen. There's Tag Heuer, some other ones. And my son asked for to see one of them, and couldn't believe it, but the price on it was like $800. I mean, the markup is just crazy on that boat. I came home and looked at some of the other watches. There's some around $200, $300, but some are under $100 on Amazon. And it's just crazy the amount of money they want for the same thing that you could come home and purchase on, at home. It's just crazy in the markup. But also, you gotta make sure that you're in the casino during the times that the boat is in international waters too, because the casino won't be open at the dock. So you have to wait for that to happen. They have every game there is in the casino though. Every slot machine, and they also have the card games too. The best thing I could say though is to make sure you watch as many YouTube videos you can of any cruise you're going to be taking, not just necessarily the Carnival Radiance, but just be prepared. That's the best thing you could do. That's what helped us, I believe, get around the boat a little bit easier. Some of the things that I knew you had to go do before you did anything else. You want to make sure you don't break any of the rules that they have, like smoking and those kind of things, loud music. You can get some heavy fines. You can be arrested for smoking in the rooms. You can't even do it out on the, if you get a deck for your room, you can't do it out there. There is a place on the boat that's towards the back, I believe, and that's where the smoking area is, but that's the only place you can do it. And so you need to be very, you need to be up on the rules and regulations that goes along with sailing on a ship, especially in different, especially going to Mexico. The ship itself, they follow federal guidelines, not state. So even though you may have a marijuana card and all those things, you just can't do it anyways. It doesn't matter. So you need to be very careful. So that's my experience on this ship. I was kind of disappointed that the areas that you're trying to get around and maneuver into aren't that great for people that have wheelchairs. That's why we ditched it the first day. That's kind of made me sad. But I had to use the cane, and of course I was in a lot of pain because of the walking we had to do. Also, you want to make sure that make sure you have the right room too. You want to make sure you have room that's for handicap and where you can wheel in and out your wheelchair. The bathroom is the same. There's no ledge, so you can just wheel right into the toilet and wheel right into the shower. But that was about it. I just want to make sure that you guys got all this information as much as I could remember to give you. Hopefully it'll help, but my best recommendation is to make sure that you look at videos and reviews from other people before you get on any ship. Doesn't matter whose it is. You got all the information there on YouTube. Just stick with that, and you should have a better experience than what I did. If I'm gonna give this out of 1 to 10, I'm gonna give it a 6. This was my first time sailing, so some of the other people that we talked to, they said that the Radiance really isn't the best flagship there is out of Carnival. They need to work on some of the things there. They still need to do some work. Remember, this boat was just refurbished. It used to be another name, and now it's the Radiance. So they, the atrium, they cut out what was there to make more rooms available so they can get more people on the boat. And I think that was really a mistake there too. I think if it was a little bit lighter, not so many people, it would have been easier to get around, and we would have enjoyed our time a lot better. But again, I'm not gonna give it a 1 or 2. I am giving it a 6 because there was some good things about it. But again, I hope all that helps you. I wanted to mention, and don't forget the affiliates that I have that I post. If you can purchase something from them, it helps me in this podcast a lot. Because I don't ask for any personal help, money out of your pocket to help me. I'm trying to do this to where I don't do that. But if you can buy something from the affiliates, they give me a percentage of whatever you buy, and that helps, and that'll work. Also, if you can, you get the opportunity to go to the other YouTube, my YouTube page. It has all my episodes there, and if you could just hit the like button, that would be great. I'm trying to build my numbers in that area so I can maybe eventually do some of these type of talks with you. Oh, I forgot. You know how I started out from the very beginning? I was going to make this a live podcast from the ship. That only lasted one day. I couldn't do it. I'm not that type of a person that can be talking and holding a stick at the same time walking around, So, maybe I'll get up my courage and do it, some more on other things. But when it came to that, I just couldn't do it. So I gave it up on the first day. But I did take pictures, and I'll make sure that you see those on the Neuropathy Support Group and Podcast on the Facebook page. Thank you all for everything that you do. I appreciate it all. I appreciate that you guys are here listening to my episodes. I know they're raw and they're uncut. And I try to do the best I can. But, that's all I have. And I'm hoping it does help you with some of the things that are going on in your life with neuropathy. It can be difficult, and it can be hard. And I know that for sure. Mine's getting worse as we go along. I see now that it's starting to affect one of my eyes. That's why I'm wearing glasses. I know you're getting some of the kind of the light feedback in them, but I wear them now because my left eye wants to turn in, and it stays there, and I can't move it back out into position. So I wear these glasses so it stays straight, because it looks kind of creepy, looking at somebody and my eyes, turned in all the way in. So I don't know. I talked to the doctor today, and I told him, I read up on it, and it is part of neuropathy issues. But you see it now, my eyes are straight. But if I take them off, see how my eye goes in? And that's supposed to be part of the neurological issues. So I'm thinking that, the neuropathy is making its way into other parts of my body. So, that's something that you need to be careful of. Also, keep track of everything that may change, so that way you can give it to your doctor. But my 20 minutes is up. Thank you guys very much for being here, and I will talk to you again. Bye.